I'm going to ask you to look into your crystal ball, which I know as a journalist you loathe to do. But tell me, when do you think we're going to have a vaccine in Canada for COVID-19?
That's a great question. We know that we have a number of candidates in phase three. By mid to late November, some of these trials are going to start to have early data, preliminary data that would give us a sense of how they're doing. The current setup at the FDA, which kind of sets the pace for the rest of the world in the U.S., is they need at least 2 months of data to make an assessment like that. So some of these phase three trials are coming close to that 2 months worth of data. So I think by the end of this year, we'll at least have a sense of whether any of these vaccines appear to be working. So then the question is going to be manufacturing, delivery, and distribution. My own prediction is I would be surprised if a year from now no one has been vaccinated. That doesn't say much, but you know that's still putting us in the realm of months rather than years. But I think really it's going to be fingers crossed for the next few weeks to the end of this year to just see if there are promising results from those phase three trials. And if they are, you know, I think that's a good indication that there will start to be vaccinations by next year.
What do we know right now in terms of how much of the population needs to take a vaccine in order for it to be effective?
I think the best answer to that question is that everyone possible, everyone who is eligible, you know, and not compromised for some reason, should take a vaccine if the vaccine is, you know, approved by regulatory agencies and shown to be effective. I think that's our best chance, because we don't know how effective the vaccine is going to be. Even after you've been vaccinated, you might still get coronavirus if it's not 100% effective, and vaccines typically are not 100% effective. So then our best chance is for everyone who can be vaccinated to be vaccinated. Are there risks? For sure there are going to be risks. But again, I, you know, balance that against the risk of having that virus in the population without any way of dealing with it. You know, one of the interesting things about this whole question of vaccination hesitancy or skepticism, is no one alive today, really, not too many people anyway, who can imagine a world without mass vaccination. And it's not a world that any of us would want to live in. Vaccines, hands down, are the most important public health intervention in human history. Saved millions and millions and millions of lives. I don't think there's any way rationally to dispute that. I'm sure people would come up with some counter argument. Vaccines have saved a lot of lives. When people are hesitant about vaccines, they're often hesitant about vaccines for illnesses that we almost never see. We have not yet experienced this situation where coronavirus is all around us, and it is affecting the economy, and it's affecting daily life and relationships and you know, and just everything about how society operates. So it's going to be really interesting to see. If you know, some people are wondering whether vaccine hesitancy is really going to be much of a factor, at least in some parts of the world, where because the imperative to get back to normal is going to be so strong. On the other hand, you know, we see evidence of people choosing not to wear masks because they don't believe in the science and other common sense interventions. So I, you know, that it's easy to imagine people being stubborn about that too.
We are in an unprecedented situation where there's an acceleration of regular science timelines around vaccine production. What advice or what words can you offer to just close up today around anybody who's feeling at all nervous about this situation in terms of how fast the science is moving?
Basically, in your own best interest, keep on top of the news surrounding us. Find good sources by responsible journalists or other sources that, you know, are telling you, you know, the changing landscape as we learn more and more. You know, one thing I try to talk to people when I'm talking about science in general is science is not like a courtroom where, you know, a judge says yes or no, makes a decision, and then we know the answer for all time. Science is like a place where new evidence is constantly being presented, and it's the accumulation of evidence that gives confidence. It works for climate change, It works for other areas of science as well, and it also works for infectious disease. It's the accumulation of evidence and the gradual filling in of the picture that provides increasing confidence with the choices that are being made. And it helps to try to have some idea of what that evidence is. And I would just say, you know, be aware of your sources, be cautious of where your information is coming from. That's my best advice.